Welcome back to NTV's Good Life. Alex Schwartz joins us in the kitchen and on the menu, and we're making something that I think it's going to be Carol's favorite here shortly. What are we making?
We are going to be making dessert nachos now.
Oh, good.
We'll see if we can get this all done in a segment. So I made some dessert chips over the weekend.
How?
Now, this is a very simple recipe. I could have done it on, but we don't have enough time to do it all. So what it is I took eight tortillas and I sliced them up into
what kind
chip
of
shapes.
Sorry.
Just flour.
Flour tortillas. Okay.
And I got the fluffy ones. I like the fluffy ones. And I put a half of a cup of butter on it and I tossed them together so they're completely covered. Then I added...
When they were cut, right?
Yeah, when they were cut. Then I added some sugar and cinnamon to them. And
so
tossed them together so they were completely covered. And then I baked them in a 400 degree oven for about 8 minutes.
Okay.
So it didn't take much.
Sugar
and cinnamon for the topping. A half of a cup, which is basically a stick of butter with eight of those and tossed it all together. And they turned out really good.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'll say.
I got
three so far.
Yes, that's why there's not more of them. Because
really
I wanted
good.
More of them.
Are those just the eight? Sorry, I'm not that I'm trying to be particular. Are they the 8-inch? Not the 8-inch or 10-inch? Because I know there's like 8, 10, and 12.
Yeah, there is. Let's see. That's taco enchilada burrito size. Is that the right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the middle
one. And Carol's
one.
Going for the big
so
one.
Did you? How come they're so still so fresh? Did you just put them in the fridge?
I didn't put
them
in the fridge. No.
Soggy or
I let them. I let them. They come out kind of soft from the butter, but once they cool down, they get hard and crunchy.
So, I'm sorry, but they're really good.
Very nice.
Okay, what can I do besides?
Okay, so what am I? What do we got going on here? What's the party going on?
All right,
we are
making hot fudge for the topping.
Oh,
because
it isn't so.
I was going through this. I'm like, oh, this is gonna be really quick. I'm like, wait, no, it can't be quick. I gotta make something. It's not just put it together. So
who makes hot fudge?
Well, we are making hot fudge.
I know it. I've never seen it made before.
All right, so I have 8 ounces of semi-sweet chips that I took. So that's not, the standard bag is 12 and this is 10. So I stuck in the microwave for 30 seconds at a time until they got completely melted. I would go 30 seconds, take it out, stir it, 30 seconds, keep going back and forth.
Them.
Exactly.
It's easy to burn.
And it would be really easy to burn them.
Yeah, that's a nice bowl too. Is that a Pampered Chef?
It is a Pampered Chef bowl.
I love those bowls.
All right, now I took some of our semi-sweet powder here and I put a third of a cup in here. And I'm just getting, it's really thick, but it's all nice and mixed together. So this is going to be the chocolate of our fudge.
Okay.
All right.
Wow, that's good.
Now, over here on the water side with Ronnie.
Is that what I got going on?
Well, sort of. It's a, let's see, I got to get my numbers right. It is 3/4 of a cup of light syrup.
Okay.
A third of a cup of heavy whipping cream. A third of a cup of sugar. Or up to half a cup. I'd go half a cup. Because I overdid it, and I like overdoing it.
Well,
and then a third of a cup of water. Now, we're getting this, and we're just mixing it until it gets all nice and dissolved.
Okay, let's take a quick break.
Perfect.
And we'll finish this recipe up with Alex.